Hello everybody, hope you all are doing well. You might have seen so many videos on basic proportionality theorem, but today in this video I'm going to demonstrate it in a tricky way so that once you see the entire video, I'm sure you can understand this theorem in a single go. As you know, Thales was a mathematician around 620 BC who made so many important theorems in mathematics, out of which one of the important theorems for class 10 says that if a line is drawn parallel to one side of this triangle, suppose this is the line which is parallel to the side BC of the triangle ABC, and intersecting other two sides, it intersects AB at the point D and AC at the points E, then according to this theorem, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. It means that the point D divides AB into the ratio AD by BD, and point E divides AC into the ratio AE by CE. Now according to this theorem says that these two other two sides are divided in the same ratio. This ratio should be same. So to understand this theorem, our two important concepts should be very clear. And both these concepts I will demonstrate practically while explaining this theorem. Alright, so let's start. Initially, we do some construction. That is, we join B to E then we join C to D, we draw perpendicular line from the point D on the side AC and another perpendicular line from point E on the side AB. So these are two perpendicular lines on the side AC and AB respectively. So we can write in the construction, we join B to E and C to D, then we draw perpendicular line from point D on the side AC. Suppose let me give this point as DG, so we can write DG perpendicular AC and if we give this point as F, so we can set EF perpendicular on AB. So this is the constructions we will do in the beginning. Our target is to prove AD by BD should be equal to AE by C. So this is our target, means this is the things we need to prove in the theorem. Now if you see the figure, AD is the base for the triangle ADE and BD is the base for the triangle BDE. To find out the ratio of AD by BD, what we can do, we can take out the ratio of area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BDE. Let me explain again why I will take area of triangle ADE by BD. As I need to find out the AD by BD, so AD is the base of triangle AD, I have taken the area of AD, and BD is the base of triangle BD, that is why I have taken the area of BD. So once we make the ratio, so area of any triangle is nothing but half into base into height, half into, here base of the triangle AD, as I said in the beginning, suppose base is AD. Once we consider AD as a base, what is the height on the base AD? EF will be the height on the base AD. Why? Why? Because if E is the top vertex, so from the top vertex to the perpendicular distance on the base is always considered as height. So EF will be the height on the base AD. To understand it more better, let me take this triangle, and if I place this triangle above on the triangle AD, we can see this is the top vertex, and the perpendicular distance from the top vertex to the base AD is the height. If we rotate it in this way, we can understand it more better. This is the top vertex. The perpendicular distance from the top vertex to the base is always considered as height. So we can say EF is the height. Now for triangle BD, area of triangle BD, same the height formula, half into base into height. Here base for the triangle BD, as we have considered BD is the base. Now what about the height on the triangle BD? We can see from top vertex E to the base BD, we cannot draw any perpendicular. So here perpendicular will be outside the triangle, that is from point E to F is a perpendicular on the base BD. Means once we extend the base BD up to point F, EF will be the perpendicular. Let's see it practically. If we take the triangle and if we place it here, this is the triangle BDE. It means that from top vertex E to the base BD, we cannot draw any perpendicular. This perpendicular will be outside the triangle on the extended base BD up to the point F. If we take this triangle and if we join it here, we can see that here the height for the triangle BDE will be outside the triangle, that is EF is the height. So if we rotate it in this way, we can understand it more better. So this will be the height for the triangle BDE, though it is outside the triangle, that is once you extend the base up to this point, this will be considered as height because this is the perpendicular distance. So we can write the height for the triangle BDE will be EF. If this conception is clear, we can solve this theorem more easily. So we can cancel EF, EF from the numerator and denominator. Half, half we can cancel, and we get the value as AD by BD. Our target was to find AD by BD, so we got the value of AD by BD, means our 50% match is done here. Similarly, to find out the value of AE by C, what we'll do? We can see AE, again we can consider the base of the triangle ADE, AE, and CE is the base of the triangle CED. So to find out the ratio of AEC, we'll take the area of the triangle ADE divided by area of triangle CED. Area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle CED. Alright, what you can write here, half into base into height, area of any triangle, this is the formula, half into, what is the base? Base for the triangle AD, if we consider AE is the base, then height on the base AE will be DG, because from top vertex D we can draw a perpendicular distance on the base AE, so DG will be the height. For area of the triangle CED, similarly the same formula, half into base into height, here half into the base for the triangle CED. If we consider CE is the base, we can see that on the base C we cannot draw any perpendicular from the top vertex D to the C. This perpendicular will be outside the triangle, that is once we extend the base C to the point G, DG will be the height for the triangle CED. Again we can cancel numerator, we can cancel because both are same, half half we can cancel, and we can write it AE by C. This you can give equation number 1, and here we can give this equation number 2. So we can write, therefore, area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle BDE is equal to, area of triangle AD by BD is equal to AD by BD, AD by BD, and area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle CED is equal to A by C. So this was our equation number 1. So we can give this equation number 1 and we can leave this as equation number 2. Now if you see both the equation 1 and 2, a very interesting things we can see here. As our target was to prove AD by BD should be equal to AE by C. So in the equation 1, the right side is AD by BD, and the equation 2, the right side is AE by C. So once you want to prove the right side is equal, our left side should be also equal. Now let us see the left side. In the left side we can see in both the equations the numerators are same, that is area of AD in the numerator first equation and area of AD numerator in the second equation. So we say that in both the equations numerators are same, but here the denominators are not same. It means that if you want to prove that both the equations equal, denominator should be also same. Means we need to prove that area of BD should be equal to area of CED. Now let's see the figure once again. Here in this figure we can see this. In the triangle BDE, the base is DE, and in the triangle CED, it also having the same base DE. And both the triangles BDE and CED are between the parallel lines DE and BC. So according to a theorem, when two triangles having same common base and between two parallel lines, the areas are same. If you want to see it practically, let me show it. Suppose this is the triangle CDE and this is the triangle BDE. So both the triangles, we can see this. In case of both the triangle, they have a common base DE and between the parallel lines DE and BC. If we reverse the triangle, we can see this more interestingly. There having common base and between the parallel lines this one and this one, means between these two lines. Now how the areas are same? If we take both the triangles in our hand, we can see this. And if we put one triangle over another triangle, we find that one triangle overlap another one. It means that when the areas are equal, then only one triangle can overlap another one. So ultimately both the triangles areas are same. Therefore we can write area of triangle BDE, that is area of this triangle BDE, is equal to area of triangle CED. It means that area of triangle CED. So ultimately we can say that the numerator of the denominator of equation 1 matches with denominator of equation 2. Therefore equation 1 we can write as area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle, is BD and CED same, so in place of BD we'll write area of triangle CED is equal to AD by BD, and this will give as equation number 3. Now if you see equation 2 and equation 3, you can find that here the left side in the equation, the numerator matches with numerator and denominator also matches with the denominator. So ultimately we can say that the left side of both the equation 2 and 3 matches, so ultimately right side also matches. So we can write, therefore AD by BD we can write is equal to A by C, and our theorem is proved here. Now let's go for a quick recap. To prove this theorem, we need to remember three very important points. The first, it was construction, means we joined B to E, C to D, and we drawn two perpendicular lines. The second point, it is formation of two equations. What you have done? We formed two equations, that is one we have formed the equation 1 and second we formed equation 2. And the third most important thing is that we need to show that areas of two triangles, are equal. It means that here you can see the two triangle was BDE and CED, that we showed that both the areas are equal. So once we remember these 3 points, you can easily solve this theorem, I'm sure. So thank you everybody for watching this video. Still any confusion, please comment on the link below. I'll work more harder to make the explanation easy for you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.